people will say, well, if you get the opportunity in life to meet your hero, don't meet him or whatever. Like, I met mine.
Woo!
Became best friends with him, traveled up and down the road, get to induct him in the Hall of Fame. I was way more nervous about inducting Rick than I was probably anything else in that entire weekend.
Ladies and gentlemen, the one and the only Nature Boy, Rick Flair!
Woo!
Thank you.
I'm just gonna talk about a little bit about everybody that from day one, if you don't mind. You got time for it?
Now Rick's doing his speech.
I was lucky enough to have a friend like Ken Patero.
And at some point, I see somebody wave from the curtain, wave me over, and I stick my head in a gorilla position, and Vince is like, how much longer's he got? He's talking about the 70s. He's not even in the 80s yet. And Vince is like, well, we're gonna get drop dead off TV. You gotta go out there and cut him off. And I'm like, you need me to walk out on stage and tell Ric Flair to wrap up his induction speech? And he's like, yes, go right now. And I'm like, oh. For the love of God, right? So I have to walk out there. And the crowd's booing, and I'm like, ugh, you gotta wrap it up. He's like, okay, and he just keeps going. Now there's a panic of people at Gorilla calling me over. Why didn't you tell him? I did tell him. Like, why isn't he wrapping it up? It's his Hall of Fame speech. And they're like, go tell him again. And I'm like, ugh.
The real leader just happens to be.
The worst possible feeling I could have is having to tell Rick, you're a legend, great, you had a great career. Get off the stage, please.
Thank you so much. Woo!
I don't even know that was a big deal to him and that he remembered it, like the whole thing's this whirlwind to him. But, oh my God, for me, it was the worst moment ever. That was like a crazy weekend.
Thank you.
But then, you can't write a better fairy tale ending.